Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I want to show you how to edit and export high-quality videos for Instagram Reels using DaVinci Resolve. Yes, we're using DaVinci, baby! And to save you time, I've created a free DaVinci project template that you can download at the link down below, which will save you a ton of time and get you editing these Reels very quickly without you needing to dial everything in manually. So, go download that template for free down below. Moving on, open up DaVinci Resolve and create a new project like I have here, and I'm gonna call it Instagram Reels Demo. Press open. And before you do anything else in your project, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go up to File, Project Settings, and then here under Timeline Resolution, you're gonna wanna change this from 3840 by 2160 or whatever it has by default for you. You're gonna wanna change that to 1080 by 1920. And then I would also change the timeline frame rate from 24 FPS to 23.976 because that matches up with the video frame rate that I filmed at. If you happen to film in a different frame rate, choose that other frame rate. Next, go down here and hit save. Import your video clips that you want to use in your video by going down here to the media pool tab. In this case, I'm gonna drag in this clip that I have of my brother in Hawaii that I filmed with my Sony a7S III and colored using my color presets, who is Matt Lutz, which you can download at the link down in the video description. And as you can see, this clip is horizontal. And so if you import a horizontal clip onto a vertical timeline, this happens in Resolve. You end up with your video scaled down and massive black bars on the top and bottom. To fix this and make your image fill the screen, you can either go up here to the inspector in the top right, and for zoom, you can start to click and drag the y-axis to the right, and that's gonna make it bigger. And once you hit about 3.165 or so, that's going to fill up the entire screen. You can then use the X position here tool to reframe your clip, and that looks really good. Alternatively, if you have a lot of horizontal clips that you're working with and you don't want to have to reframe each of them manually, press Control Z a few times to bring this back down to where it was. Instead, you can go up here to your timeline in the top left, right click on it, go to Timelines, Timeline Settings, and then uncheck the Use Project Settings box. And then here under Mismatch Resolution, change this to Scale Full Frame with Crop. And then under Output, also make sure you change the mismatched resolution here to Scale Full Frame with Crop as well. Press OK, and DaVinci is now going to automatically zoom in all of your video clips so they fill up the frame completely. You can then select your clip and go over to the X position and reframe as you need to. In this case, I think this looks really good. And let's now say that we're done editing this video and it's time to render it. So we're gonna click on the rocket ship render icon down here in the bottom. And then over here on the left for your render settings under file name, let's call this Who is Matt Reel. You can name it whatever you want. And then for location, you're going to want to click browse and select where you want to save your video file. This is really important because if you don't select where you save it, you're not going to know where your video file is. And you're definitely going to want to know that. Next, for format, you're going to want to select QuickTime, and for codec, H.264. Then we have some very important settings that we need to cover. First, under resolution, make sure that is set to 1080 by 1920. That way your rendered video matches up with your sequence and everything looks vertical like it should for Instagram Reels. And for frame rate, select 23.976 if that is the frame rate that you filmed in. And then the most important thing, you have the quality setting here. And by default, it's gonna choose automatic best, but I would recommend changing this because you need to keep in mind that Instagram is not going to process the reel very much before it's published. So you do not want to upload too big of a video file because that may make Instagram throw you an error and say that it can't upload the reel or may play back your video weird, etc. So to avoid that, I would select the restrict option here and restrict your video, double click to type, to 3,500 kilobits per second, which is still plenty for a small 1080p video that's gonna be played on a small phone screen. And then down here under rate control, I would change this from VBR high quality to constant bit rate, which is going to basically tell DaVinci to always give your video the full amount of data, which is gonna help prevent compression artifacts in your video. Worst case scenario, if you export your video and you're seeing some compression artifacts and the quality doesn't look as good as you would like, feel free to raise this 3,500 kilobits per second number higher to 5,000 kilobits per second or 10,000, but keep in mind that the video file size is going to get larger because of that, and this could lead to issues when you upload to Instagram, which is why I recommend on average 3500 kilobits per second. With that, the last thing you need to do is select Add to Render Queue down here in the bottom, and then over here on the right, click Render All, and your video will be rendering. And within a few seconds or minutes, depending on the speed of your computer, you will have an Instagram reel ready for you to upload. Then it's a simple matter of using an app like Dropbox or AirDrop to transfer the file from your computer to your phone where you can upload it. With that, thank you so much for watching this Instagram Reels tutorial for DaVinci Resolve. Remember that you can still download the free Instagram Reels template file down below that will get you editing Reels even faster in Resolve. Also, speaking of Resolve, this is the first video that I've made about DaVinci Resolve, but I'm planning on making a lot more and branching out to use other video editing software. So please, leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think. Do you want to see more videos about DaVinci? What videos would you like to see? How can I help you with this program? Let me know. All right, thanks so much for watching and have a great day.